locking in Jamie, I believe, on the Enhancement Shaman. So playing Enhancement Shaman, Frostmage, Restoration Druid. Not a composition you see often, but, you know, Templestorm with their limited roster right now, not having their fourth Botar here, they had to come up with something quickly.
I mean, in the current meta, Enhancement Shaman off-healing is incredibly powerful. Frostmage received an Azerite trait buff, so Alec is running the Ice Form build. Every minute, he gets a massive boost of intellect, and basically Templestorm are trying to take advantage of what is most strong in the meta. So this composition seems like it's not going to work, right? You've got Polymorph that's on the same DR as Hex. It seems like it's a little bit of a mismatch, but these are some of the most powerful specializations in the meta, and Templestorm, I feel, are experimenting with them combined together.
Yeah, Templestorm and Method Black both going to be utilizing that. So basically, instead of using the Icy Veins, they opt for the Ice Form. That's going to be a 1 minute cooldown, and every minute, they're going to get a big boost of intellect that they can burst with. They lose out on that additional haste, but the amount of int that they get is incredible, so look for big burst when that does happen.
Raikou already on the back foot. Nixie's getting a lot of excellent crowd control on Chaz, and it's putting Method Black quite behind. Let's see how Chaz deals with this recovery. Raikou out of line of sight. Nice Frost Nova by Alec. That's putting Raikou further behind. Alec looking for more cheeky polymorphs. Full polymorph. This is amazing crowd control from Tempo Storm on this new unorthodox meta comp. They need to try and get an ice block with this crowd control, but they don't manage to keep the chain going. Waz denies it, and Raikou, I believe, is likely to recover. Now Method Black look to attack back.
That kidney shot on Nixie. Big swap on him. No trinket available. Can they take him down? Activates the bark skin to make himself tankier. He's going to be able to escape with that. Looking for a cyclone. Goes into the Moonkin form. That's going to make him immune to polymorph.
Whoa!
Alec, in the meantime, getting bursted down. Ray of Frost from Raikou. Can he get him down? No. The iron bark will deny from Nixie. And now Alec looking to strike back.
One way to punish a Restoration Druid. Nixie's running that balance affinity. That's why you see him occasionally running around as a laser chicken with antlers. That allows him to avoid polymorph and cast heals on his partners. And it's really good against mages. But if you switch to the druid playing this affinity, he's very squishy. He doesn't get the guardian druid bear form. I really want to see if Method Black look to punish that. They've gotten Nixie's trinket. They've gotten his bark skin. He's a wide open target for a swap. And it looks like they're going to try and make that swap now. This is their opening. Will Nixie fall? He's getting healed by Jamie. They don't properly cross crowd control. And that lack of crowd control by Method Black is going to lose them a kill opportunity.
Yeah, so Jamie has a lot of support from Nixie in this matchup. Nixie, like you said, very vulnerable. At the same time, Jamie on that shaman has a lot of off-healing, has the grounding totem to prevent a lot of Raikou's damage. So if, like you said, they don't use that cross crowd control on Jamie, get the double CC out when they're making these swaps on a Nixie, it's not going to be too effective. Nixie now trading out his trinket for the blind. That's a fair trade. Ooh. Meantime, Raikou getting bursted down. A lot of damage from Jamie. That's one of the things about the Enhancement Shaman.
Nice.
They have such high consistent damage, and it seems to be working out very well for Templestorm.
I mean, Chaz is almost doom. Raikou is down an ice block. This is looking so good for Templestorm. They've got more crowd control for Chaz. Nixie has been on fire with these Cyclones. Raikou in desperation is trying to get back to the pillar with Chaz. He's likely to recover in this defensive position. Waz is trying to go after Nixie and force Barkskin and then later on get a kill. But Alec is backing him up and Nixie follows it up with the Cyclones. Now Star Surging Raikou. Nixie's team is so far ahead. Immense pressure. Chaz is almost completely tapped on mana. Raikou is likely to have to trade his final ice block if Jamie can stay on target. This could easily be it. Raikou blocks. And Chaz is oom. Tempo Storm are going to take game one against Method Black.
Yeah, there's a Cyclone on Chaz. They're looking to crowd control through this ice block to finish him off very, very early. Raikou jumps out, interrupting the polymorph, but it looks like he doesn't care. He's pulling the trigger anyways. Raikou's still in a lot of trouble. If Jamie can reconnect, a nice double fear coming in from
Chaz. Oh, no.
Alive. Big swap on Nixie. They got the cross crowd control with the fear on Jamie. He trinkets out to support Nixie. Keep him alive just a little bit longer. Tempo Storm needs to not throw these last few moments. They are so far ahead.
They have the game in the bag. The only person that can die right now in Tempo Storm is Nixie in a stun or Jamie in a stun with Smoke Bomb in 25 seconds. But Method Black have to survive another 23 seconds. They're out of mana. They're out of blocks. Double stun secured by Jamie. He's pushing forward to nail the kill, interrupting the polymorph and trying to stay aggressive. They purge those powered shields off every time Raikou could be in trouble. Good polymorphs on Jamie. Nice counterspell on Alec. Raikou taking control of the match. He needs to pause it out as long as possible, but Chaz has no mana at this point. As soon as these polymorphs end, Jamie's going to be putting out immense counter pressure. Waz is locked down in Cyclones. Nixie is on fire on this druid in this game. This is it. They have to kill Nixie. Jamie's not in crowd control. He can support. Raikou needs to support. They need to not throw away the game. Raikou falls amidst the swap. And Tempo Storm, being down the fourth member, subbing in Nixie on the alternate healer, take down the best team in the world in game one.
You know, I jumped in a team we have ever seen in a season leading up to BlizzCon. Will they be able to grab a game here and tie up the series?
All right, Tempo Storm, they have the lead, but now Method Black have switched to the Restoration Druid, hoping to get a bit longer of a match so they don't run out of steam. With the Discipline Priest, they were not able to push Tempo Storm over. That sub out is going to allow them for a longer match. Waz sneaking across the playing field, looking for a sap. And as soon as Alec comes out of invisibility, I would imagine he is the sap target. So Waz is really being patient, waiting for that. Now Alec is visible. Waz needs to make a move quickly, but not able to find combat. Now he may try to sap Nixie. He's not able to get that either. He's going to cheap shot Nixie. Once again, playing that balanced druid affinity. They're going to open with blind. They get Nixie's trinket. Waz held on to Vendetta. Raikou held on to Ice Form. So now that they've got Nixie's trinket basically for free, they're likely to switch to him. And Tempo Storm need to be ready to protect.
Yeah, Jamie's going to have to trade out his trinket if they do get the cross crowd control on him. And that's what we're looking for Method Black in this matchup. You can see Raikou's going to be taking a little bit of damage right now. As long as Jamie is on top of Raikou, he's going to be putting out significant damage. The Enhancement Shaman, he can be kited, but if he has uptime, one of the highest damage classes in the game.
All right, we see a bash on Nixie. They're not going after him. They're trying to cross crowd control two members, but not able to find it just yet. They were able to stall it out long enough for Nixie to get out of that stun. Ultimately, now getting a Cyclone on Chaz, and Nixie's crowd control has been immaculate, but with this counterspell secured by Raikou, Alec is falling behind, taking immense damage and actually forced to block first. Method Black with a lead.
Yeah, good damage coming in from Waz and Raikou. That Ebon Bolt with the Ice Form going to be putting out tons of damage on Alec. He didn't want to mess around with no Ironbark available. Jamie now getting crowd controlled, and Method Black this game with Chaz on the Wrestle Druid has been able to slow down the damage of Temple Storm just by so much. You can see Jamie into the Polymorphs, out of the Polymorphs, going to be put into the Cyclone. So just excellently done by Method Black, and that's a kind of Wrestle Druid Mage crowd control we're really looking for when we look at a team like this.
Ooh, counterspell on Nixie. Raikou's nailed two of those in a row now. That's putting Alec immensely far behind. That's just an extra crowd control that doesn't have a diminishing return. Nixie trades Ironbark to recover through this pressure. Seems to be restabilizing. Now Raikou on the back foot gets cloned at low health, allowing Jamie to march his way slowly back to the target. The Cyclone by Nixie was very well timed. Jamie is able to reconnect. Nice Cyclone on Waz, so he can't interrupt the Ray of Frost. Chaz with an equally good Cyclone to interrupt Alec's Ray of Frost. Both teams playing at the top level.
Yeah, Sid sort of mentioned the balance affinity earlier on. Here's a nice setup, though, coming in from Method Black. Yeah, big burst on Alec, forcing out the second ice block. But that balance form, or balance affinity for both druids, allows them to go into that Moonkin form, and that makes them immune to Polymorph. So the only crowd control that these mages are going to get out is a Ring of Frost, and they have to be set up in order to do that. So it's going to be a bash coming in from Nixie, or potentially a Kidney Shot or Cheap Shot coming in from Waz, and that's going to set up these mages to get that crowd control that they need.
All right, currently in this position, Alec is not looking too hot. Down two ice blocks, blind on Nixie. Now the trinket for the healer is out of the way. Method Black have a clear win condition with the next Vendetta if they don't even find one before that point. Tempo Storm need to pull off a miracle. They're incredibly far behind. There's no significant openings. They need to just drag this fight out for another 2 minutes, try and reset their cooldowns, but I don't think they're going to make it to that point. They're trying to go for a miracle kill over onto Chaz, bashing him and swapping targets. He's going to survive trading Barkskin. That does leave him a little bit softer moving forward. Maybe if Jamie can stay on target, he can get a lot of pressure. He's using that pillar to line of sight Chaz's clones and still be able to stay on target by ducking in and out around the corners. It's good positioning by Jamie. They've got control of Raikou. They're getting decent uptime. Waz is trying to peel the whole team and set up for victory here, but he's still got to wait 16 seconds. He's going to need that Vendetta burst. Next crowd control on Nixie could be the end of the match.
Yeah, you need to watch Waz in these restealths. That set him up there. He was able to restealth, get a cheap shot on the Jamie, cheap shot on Nixie, and a Garrote on Alec. So every time he gets those restealths off, it's going to allow him to CC the entire enemy team with those silences, with those stuns. So Temple Storm, they have to do an excellent job making sure that they stop Waz from pulling that off. Normally, you can only do that with his Vanish every 2 minutes, and unless they kind of forget about him after a CC chain and allowing him to get those stealths off.
All right, counterspell on Chaz. Jamie is swapping to him. It seems like they're just going to rush down Chaz. That's their only option. Kill Chaz before Vendetta is applied to Alec, because if they don't, right here could be the end of the match. No trinkets. Vendetta popped. Perfect crowd control. Method Black come back strong in game two.
They are going to be able to tie up this series, and we need to talk about what change really was able to grab it for him. Is it strategy? Is it the fact that they do change their Hail Air Zeke?
Good control with two Cyclones now coming in from Tempo Storm.
Yep, Balanced Druid's receiving a buff in the recent patch. They're definitely a force to be contended with. Let's see how Alec performs. Obviously, Method Black can win similarly with that triple crowd control, but Alec will have the advantage of Bear Form, more consistently rather than having to trade ice blocks. So Alec needs to get in this bear form before he thinks that an attack is incoming. He can reduce the pressure and be more likely to survive. Method Black move in, setting up crowd control on Alec, but no real cross crowd control onto any of the other members. No advantage just yet. Now Polymorph on Jamie. Looks like they want to go after Alec, but he's already in bear form. He's quite more durable in this position. Let's see what cooldowns Method Black commit. Just the ice form. That trades one for one with the ice form with the bark skin. Now he gets Cyclone low health. This is great by Chaz, just pausing the game out, making it difficult for Nixie to get his heal over time effects going. Now blinded. They get a trinket. They could swap to him. It's a small map, or they could just push through and finish Alec. Waz on the back foot. They're trying to force him off of Alec, but it's not looking too good. He's dangerously low.
Yeah, Method Black with masterful control in the beginning of that game. Kitty shot now on Nixie. Alex still could be in some trouble. More polymorphs going out onto Jamie. In the meantime, Raikou taking a bit of damage. You can see Chaz, he responds. Going to be using Innervate as well as that tree form, empowering his heals. Basically, his team cannot die while that is up, or unless he's crowd controlled, but it doesn't look like they have the crowd control for him. So Method Black's going to be very safe for the time being. In the meantime, Temple Storm's looking to get aggressive with Alex Incarnation, and it doesn't look like they're able to really get too much done.
Sure. Double crowd control, but Jamie's open. He can stop a lot of this. He actually mistimed the grounding totem. That polymorph is secured. Now Alex in the 3v2. He's going to need some help. Chaz is actually getting tunneled down, gets cycloned away. Good crowd control here by Method Black. They're going to commit the Vendetta to this attempt. Alex still locked and alone. He's going to be able to handle this. It looks like he's doing just fine. He's recovering perfectly fine. That's a great trade. Now the Vendetta threat's out of the way. Tempo Storm can maybe start to get aggressive. Maybe not. Alec falls behind all of a sudden with just a kidney shot on Nixie. Jumps back into that bear form and gets cycloned low health. So every time Method Black goes for a kill, they try to pull cooldowns from Tempo Storm. As soon as they estimate that the kill is lost, they then cyclone Alec at low health to make it difficult for Nixie to time his heals. Nice sneaky polymorph here by Raikou. Unfortunately, Alec got pre-iron barked, so he's got damage reduction. He's in bear form and unlikely to die. That was a nice read by Nixie, baiting or expecting the polymorph and just trading a defensive cooldown, getting the diminishing return out of the way. Now Tempo Storm should have an opening to start getting counter pressure.
Yeah, Alec looking to get some damage out right now, finally in the Moonkin form, putting out some pressure. And you look at Chaz's mana, he has to go for a drink, already on 50%, so he's going to be running away. It's going to be up to Alec and Jamie to stop him. DR kitty shot on Alec, just looking to buy Chaz as much time as possible and avoid some damage, but Temple Storm, they know their win condition. They're not going to let Chaz sneak away and get any drinks. Full bash now on Nixie. Do they have the follow-up crowd control? Doesn't look like it. And now they actually managed to get the full poly. Very nicely done by Raikou there, and Alec is forced into the bear form once again. He's going to be tanking out. A lot of this damage still has the bar skin available, but Method Black really struggling to take down Alec despite having really good crowd control.
Yeah, Tempo Storm have basically built a triple healer composition with Jamie backing him up in bear form, making Alec much more tanky on these setups, and it really denies the kills during that crowd control window that Method Black need to win. And Tempo Storm are attritioning their opponents by running Chaz out of mana. Every time Nixie gets crowd control for an extended period of time, guess what he's not doing? He's not casting spells. He's not spending mana. He's actually, in fact, regenerating it. So it's very unlikely that Method Black win this on mana. It's going to be perfect crowd control, a swap, and a smoke bomb. If they can bait a trinket from Jamie, they could make that maneuver. Unfortunately, at this point, Tempo Storm have almost completely reset their defensive cooldowns. There's no clear way to victory for Method Black. They need to start whittling down the defense, but they're slowly falling on the back foot with all three members at 50%, and Tempo Storm are looking good with this composition.
Yeah, Tempo Storm just has so much damage. Chaz getting swapped, dude, almost getting soloed there by Jamie. Ducks out of line of sight, so he's going to be able to, you know, keep himself alive as Alec cannot commit any more damage. He's a full blind sap over onto Nixie. Threw out the pre-iron bark on that setup. Also threw out his trinket, so Alec does survive that, still having the bark skin. I don't think they've been able to pull that from him the entire game. Chaz now looking for some cyclones. Gets interrupted by Alec. Nicely done. Still looking to get that pressure rolling, but Chaz manages to stabilize his team.
All right, Nixie, I think it's just going to get tunneled down. And he actually went out of bear form right before the kidney shot. This is devastating for him. It could cost a lot of momentum. Alec trying to support with Cyclones gets line of sighted on the boxes. Nixie likely needs to reposition. They managed to get Barkskin and Trinket from Nixie. He's now a vulnerable target, as well as Alec with no Trinket. They could smoke bomb him. So there are clear ways to victory right now for Method Black, but they're on a clock. The mana advantage is going to be towards Tempo Storm. Their composition is more durable. It's built for an attrition fight. So it's up to Method Black to be the aggressors in this map. And they've been catching Nixie out of form. All of these kidney shots are perfect, but they're not cross-crowd controlling Jamie. Every time Nixie Nixie's health bounces back up in the stun. That's Jamie healing him. So they need to cross crowd control Jamie. That could have been a kill right there if they had anything for him. And now they've lost another opportunity.
It's not just Jamie, though. Alec is also just spamming out the regrowth. So at the back, they have to CC everybody if they want to get a kill. If Alec is just throwing out regrowth, Nixie's not going to die. If Jamie's just spamming out the healing surges, Nixie's not going to die. So Temple Storm, I think this is a good pick from them. And Method Black, they're going to have to execute perfectly if they want to land a kill. Or they're just going to have to wait and extend out the game into dampening where those hybrid heals just aren't as powerful.
Nice pre-Iron Bark by Nixie. Waz wanted to go for that smoke bomb play out of range, but Nixie read it, pre-Iron Barked. Obviously, Nixie plays a rogue, so he may know the win conditions for Method Black just as well as they do, so he read that situation perfectly, and what would have been ultimately maybe the game for their team, Nixie just denies it completely by reading the moves of Method Black. We've now stepped into dampening. Chaz's mana is looking even worse. He's falling behind. Fortunately, he has defensive cooldowns. Here's another crowd control window. Because Tempo Storm didn't trinket blind instantly, Nixie has to sit through this, and it could open a window to kill Alec if he doesn't respond appropriately. He's being very greedy, not bark skinning in that bear form, still holding on to it. Nixie sitting through more polymorphs. Waz, though, dipping low. Jamie's constantly been switching to Chaz, and that's really important against a Resto Druid, is to switch targets. That way he has to apply hots to everyone on his team. That costs the most amount of mana, and that's the strategy that Tempo Storm are playing for. Run Chaz out of mana, rot the whole team, and get a triple kill. They've been playing perfectly in this matchup, and Method Black are just falling more and more behind.
This has to be devastating for Method Black. They had a really nice crowd control train on Nixie, and Alec, he didn't even bark skin, not really respecting the incoming damage, especially if Jamie's there to support him with those heals like we kind of been talking about. Chaz, finally, he gets out of combat looking for a drink. If he can get that drink channel long enough, he can regenerate his mana. Unfortunately, that was stopped, so won't be able to regen his mana. And now Temple Storm, they still have that lead, but a nice setup coming in from Method Black. Alec still, though, just not really, he's not in trouble. So he still has the renewal, still has the bar skin, still has his trinket. Nixie's still in crowd control, but Alec's just fine.
They need to take all three members out of the game at the same time, or else one of their members can save the stun locked. So Jamie saved Alec there. He doesn't even have to trade cooldowns, but these cyclones from Chaz could open windows of opportunity. Raikou trying to get some icicles off the back of this. I don't think they have enough momentum. Nixie has cooldowns. Swapping to Nixie right now, I think, is their only option, but they're just going to go after Alec, maybe try and burst him down with dampening and assisting them. They managed to pull at least Iron Bark from Nixie. Now Alec is trying to deny drinks, but if he overextends too far, that could be an opportunity to kill him. I really like this from Chaz. Perhaps he should have been trying to do this earlier into the match, but the map is not playing to their advantage, and I believe this was map selection by Tempo Storm, so this is a nice pick. Pick the small map so the Druid can't drink, play for the long game, run him out of mana, and unless Chaz gets a drink, it's looking worse and worse.
Yeah, it's not looking too good, but Method Black, they have some pressure here. Nice setup coming in from Chaz. Cyclone on Alec into a bash on the Nixie. Kidney shot now on Alec, and the full Cyclone. Jamie, like you said, though, he's completely open. He drops a Grounding Totem, denies a lot of damage, throwing out the heals. Alec should be fine, but still good pressure coming in from Method Black, and like I said, if they can hold on just a little bit longer, dampening really favors their composition in terms of limiting the amount of off heals that Alec and Jamie provide for their team.
They've got a strong composition in the meta. They're playing to the strategy of just running the attrition fight, run them out of mana. They pick the perfect map. It's so difficult as a healer on this small map to get far enough away and actually sit down and drink, which regenerates your mana. Unless Tempo Storm throw the game, this is looking more and more in the bag for them, and then they'll move to match point against Method Black. Blind on Nixie, trades out trinket, fair and equivalent trade. Chaz is falling so far behind. They need to get a kill soon, but they're just not able to find enough damage. Alec tanks it out. Perhaps if he's greedy, Alec can go down. There's a smoke bomb available. If he is greedy, he will lose. They go after Nixie. They catch him out of form. This is another win condition, but they have to kill him.
Uh-oh.
What is that damage? Uh-oh. Out of nowhere, Method Black pull a victory out of what should have been certain defeat. Obviously, Tempo Storm want to play this out. Chaz has no mana. Everybody on his team is very low, so they're going to keep going for triple pressure and potentially get a cross kill. However, I would say it is pretty unlikely.
Yeah, Waz, he has a Cloak of Shadow, so they have those immunities. Chaz really has no mana left. And Temple Storm, they kind of threw this game away. Alec and Jamie, they got way too tunnel visioned on the mana. They left Nixie wide open. That's the only reason why he was staying alive. And at this point, it's looking pretty hopeless for Temple Storm. Alec slowly and surely going to go down, and I just don't think they have the damage to close this one out.
I don't know. Oh, Chaz got a drink. That, I think that's enough mana with Tree Form.
Oh, Tree Form, yeah.
I think it is.
We've been wrong before, but
I know. That's why I'm not counting them out.
I think the Broccoli Boys should be able to do it here.
Yeah, the Tree of Life.
Is that what we're calling that now? Broccoli?
Well, as soon as Alec is...
That's old.
Yeah, as soon as Alec...
That's old?
Yeah, that's
broccoli
old.
Broccoli form?
Come on. No, I know the form, but we call it broccoli.
It was in the tooltip. I think Sid's a new kid.
Yeah. But what I was saying is, as soon as Alec's in this position where he has to be in bear form, they no longer have a chance to really...
Place.
A fitting final resting place.
Why? Every week.
I just dropped the mic.
It's my line, okay? It's my line. The one thing
I like your line.
The one thing I want to see Alec do in the late game is, well, first, Jamie should attack Waz. When Chaz is Zoom and the game is so late and dampening, Jamie should tunnel Waz because he gets 100% uptime and can do the most amount of damage. Alec should save his Astral Power and save it only for Starfall, which is super effective at stopping drinks. If Alec saves Starfall and Jamie tunnels down the Rogue, what can Chaz do? He's in checkmate at that point. He can't drink and Waz is taking too much damage. We see Waz and Jamie taking an initial exchange as Method Black have actually changed their targeting in this game, realizing the Boomkin in bear form, too tanky. Jamie off-healing him, not going to be enough to really get a kill. But if you go after Jamie and save Counterspell for Alec, you can remove three members from the game. And I like this target swap for Method Black.
Well, it can't get much worse than Alec, honestly. They weren't able to punish him really at all in that last game, so I think it's smart. But Jamie on that Enhancement Shaman, very, very tanky. He has the Astral Shift, which is very powerful. He's playing Dwarf, which is very effective against the Assassination Rogue. It can remove all of the bleeds and poison effects, so he can keep himself alive with that. But so far, Method Black, they're finding a lot more pressure with this new target.
Yeah, Jamie on the back foot for some time. Alec's support on Jamie is an instant cast. He has a cast Regrowth, he has a cast Cyclone. Those are interruptible. Whereas when Jamie supports Alec, Healing Surge is instant. It's not interruptible. It has to be crowd controlled, and it's much easier to execute. I also think another strategy for Method Black is to just put all their crowd control on Jamie and Alec, never CC Nyxie, and try and burn his mana down the same way that Chaz is. If they could do that, they could tie mana in dampening and maybe get a kill through that method.
Yeah, it's definitely possible. You know, Waz maybe doesn't provide as much consistent damage as Jamie, but he has that reduction in healing with the wound poison, which is very, very effective. So it definitely could be an option for them. It'd be an interesting strategy to see. There's a bash on the Waz. He trinkets out of that, wants to keep the pressure rolling. Now full bash on Nyxie. Another setup here on Jamie with a full kidney shot, but a nice beam coming in from Alec. That's going to be silencing up Raikou as well as Chaz. But still, Jamie getting bursted down. The CC hasn't ended yet. Still a Cyclone on to Nyxie. Jamie throwing out the heals. Astral Shift on him. There's the full Polymorph, and Temple Storm could be in a lot of trouble.
See that Counterspell icon next to Alec? He was just kicked earlier. This is a great setup by Method Black. It banked them all the vital defensive cooldowns that they need to get from Jamie to get a kill moving forward. There's a massive window if they can execute like that once again. The only way that Tempo Storm can play around it is if Alec can fake cast Raikou's Counterspell, fake cast the Shadow Step of Waz. If Alec can fake cast that interrupt, get the Cyclones to save Jamie, they will be able to survive.
Whoa.
What was that damage? Out of nowhere, Raikou on the back foot, having to ice block. Waz now getting swapped to. He has the Cloak of Shadows, and Tempo Storm, they're in a position now where they can take out Waz, and suddenly that win condition I thought that Method Black had is starting to slip away.
Yeah, Waz still on the retreat. Raikou behind the pillar as well. Chaz has to catch up at this point in the game, but it looks like Temple Storm, Method Black, they're going to be playing full defense, just trying to avoid some damage. But Temple Storm, they realize the pressure they have. They're pushing in. Waz, no evasion, no Cloak of Shadows, no really nothing available. Chaz channels out a full Tranquility there. That's going to be very, very huge. And now Nyxie, he trinkets out of the blind into a cheap shot. If there's any follow-up from Raikou, this is so scary for Jamie. He's all alone. Counterspell on Alec. Beautiful setup coming in from Method Black, but Jamie with his off-heels keeping himself alive in a nice pre-Ironbark, I believe, from Nyxie is just going to be so strong.
Yeah, that pre-Ironbark play was well done by Nyxie, but they managed to get both Jamie's trinket and Nyxie's trinket. Unfortunately, Waz isn't actually playing Smoke Bomb. I guess he's going for an Honor Talent to get more sustained damage as he knows his game is likely to go into dampening, and I think Method Black could play the mana game. They make a swap. They catch Nyxie out of form. A massive mistake by Nyxie could cost them the series. Barkskin will stabilize Jamie's support, gets Nyxie a second opportunity to stay in the match, but if he makes mistakes like that again, he could throw the game for his team.
Yeah, I don't think Jamie and Alec are going to be leaving Nyxie alone like they did in Dalaran Sewers. They were so far ahead, so that's got to be a nightmare situation for them once again, seeing Nyxie all alone. Luckily,
double bash
back, but a nice bash on Waz. Do they have the damage to take him down? Ironbark gets thrown out. Waz on 1%, barely surviving. Alec's putting out so much damage. A nice kick on Cyclone from Wazo. Now a big swap Nyxie on Nyxie once again. Here comes the kidney shot with an interrupt on Alec, but Jamie just free casting and easily keep Nyxie alive.
Yeah, they didn't take Jamie out of the fight during that Sunlock, so he just saves Nyxie. Waz now on the back foot, and Tempo Storm's damage has been much more consistent this game than Dalaran. They've obviously warmed up. Double Solar Beam. Alec gets roasted. Tempo Storm, take this to game 5.
And what a nice solar beam to end that one from Alec right there, hitting Chaz right on his cast right there, as Waz didn't have his
close storm all the way through this bracket. Will they be able to take out one of the most dominant teams of the year and get that much closer to BlizzCon? Are they going to have to sit here and watch the next series and just hope that Skillcat Red choke?
We'll have to see. I expect Temple Storm to honestly play this very defensively. I expect them to just sit on this large pillar, just force Method Black to push in if they want to get any sort of pressure and momentum and not go into the midfield where Raikou really does have that Frost Mage advantage.
Yeah, right now Temple Storm in a good group hug position, but they're all locked in crowd control. That's going to force a cooldown trade, potentially a kill unless Jamie can get some off-heels rolling. He manages to get out of that Polymorph, toss out a couple healing surges, and even just a few of those is enough to stall out the match. But you can see how much more of a dangerous situation that was for Alec. He had to trade his entire defensive arsenal because Method Black isolated him. Even with good positioning, they were able to take and pull all those cooldowns. Now they can go onto him with another clean setup like that and potentially do it again. Will Method Black be able to race against the clock is the question. Tempo Storm have already shown that they can throw games away. Nixie hasn't been playing perfectly on Dalaran or Runes of Lordaeron. He gets caught out of form. And those kind of mistakes is going to be things that Method Black look to punish. So it's a race to see if they're going to choke. They make a swap on Nixie. They're trying to bait a trinket on this and then blind him and switch to Alec. Nixie's being greedy. It was a very greedy play to not actually trade Barskin on that stunlock, but without Alec or Jamie taken out of the fight, they can just support him, and he kind of gets away with that.
Yeah, it's not super greedy, honestly. If you have two hybrids just healing you up, I think Nixie was, you know, right in his mind there to not throw away any sort of defensives. Nice little bash over onto Waz now. It looks like he's going to be using his trinket, trying to get away as Chaz gets interrupted. Jamie using that Ascendance. Those are the two scary moments for Method Black. When you see Jamie has that Ascendance up, that makes all of his damage range. Alec, when he uses his incarnation, he gets that armor on his character, which increases the amount of damage he does as well. Chaz normally responds with that incarnation tree of life, where he goes into the tree form and increases his healing. So Method Black, they realize when they are in trouble and when they can get ahead.
Good triple crowd control that forces Jamie to trinket. So by switching to Jamie, Alec has to cast his utility. He gets interrupted twice in a row by Method Black. Good interrupt usage, good crowd control on Nixie. Now they've got trinket off the healer, they've got trinket off the enhancement shaman, they've got a clear route to victory. Vendetta up in 14. Method Black need to cleanly set this up for a kill on Jamie. I think they're going to be walking away with the series.
Yeah, Raikou putting nice crowd control over onto Jamie as they try to get some damage rolling on Alec, but unfortunately not able to find the pressure. Now Waz once again in a little bit of trouble. We saw Waz be a little bit more aggressive with his defensives in the last game with the evasion and the Cloak of Shadows, but he's holding onto those now. Alec still in some trouble. Kidney shot on Jamie. Nixie gets caught into the cheap shot. 3-on-1 situation here as they make a swap over onto Jamie, actually. He's going to be taking most of this damage, but healing himself up, running away in Ghost Wolf, and it looks like Raikou's not really going to be able to connect too much damage.
If they can keep Alec and Nixie out, no, Jamie's just able to kite away and heal himself. If they don't have Jamie locked in Kidney Shot, I think it's almost impossible for him to go. Maybe if they can extend it long enough to run him out of Maelstrom. Now a Kidney Shot with a Cyclone, but Iron Bark connected by Nixie. Will Iron Bark be enough is then the question. It appears to be the case with Cyclones, but Jamie gets Cycloned at low health. Method Black waiting for crowd control. They get it. They get the full Polymorph. Method Black have got immaculate crowd control in this position. I thought the kill was lost maybe 10 seconds ago, but they've just kept the chain rolling. Unfortunately, they drop it in the final seconds, and potentially Jamie hangs on by a thread. Now getting counter pressure on Waz, bashing him up, dishing out a ton of pain. Cyclone on Nixie. I'm very surprised to see Jamie survive in that position. That was perfect crowd control for the better part of 30 seconds, and it's still continuing.
Yeah, he's still in a lot of trouble, though. Actually, he has the Astral Shift up now. Still trying to kite away. Nixie has his HOTS rolling on him. Full cycle now on Chaz. Nicely done by Alec. They're trying to set something up on Waz, trying to get some counter pressure. You know, we need to see Temple Storm get some pressure and momentum on their side of the field because Method Black is bossing all over him.
Solar Beam Bash combo. Nice play from Temple Storm. Gets them Cloak of Shadows from Waz. That's going to be the plays that Temple Storm move for. Use that Solar Beam to interrupt Chaz on a healer or Cyclone. Bash up the Rogue and try and burst him down. But here comes crowd control from Method Black. They get Nixie's Trinket in this attempt, which is a vital cooldown. Now they're looking to get Jamie's with the follow-up. They're just Cycloning, pausing the game out, trying to hold on to mana and extend the game as long as they can. But I believe Nixie has a heavy mana lead at this point. It's hard to tell until he shifts out of Bear Form. But he wants to be in Bear Form to avoid Polymorph. Jamie caught in a stun, but not long enough to really find a kill. So now Temple Storm need to start getting aggressive. All the crowd control diminishing returns are used up. Alec is getting on top of Chaz, trying to get some pressure going, but he gets controlled. Method Blackheart really good at this defusing. This is where the map pick comes into play. Chaz can run so far away, and this is where Jamie and Alec overextended on Dalaran and threw the match. Nixie got baited into the middle of the map and polymorphed. I think this is happening again. If they can force Jamie's trinket, nice counterspell, they get Jamie's trinket. Perfect setup for Method Black. If they can do that one more time, they can close out the game.
Yeah, but look at how sad Temple Storm is. Chaz, he sat down, he used that drink and regenerated his mana to basically a full reset. Has 100% mana at this point in the game, and that was one of the win conditions for Temple Storm. So they really need to be on top of stopping those drinks from Chaz. Unfortunately, this map, like we said, it really plays into the favor of Method Black. Now a nice little setup coming in from Temple Storm. They're trying to get something rolling on Waz, but Jamie, realizing he's in a little bit of trouble, retreating to the pillar once again. He just wants to overextend Waz in these situations, get that pressure rolling, purge off the hots from Chaz, and this is where they can really see some momentum going. But a nice setup now being reversed by Method Black.
Alec trinkets to save Jamie. Will he get interrupted? He gets interrupted. He doesn't fake the counterspell. Nice play by Raikou, but they drop the chain. Nixie connects Iron Bark, and Jamie is likely to survive in this position. Method Black had great cross crowd control, but they dropped the ball, locking Nixie out. If they could have kept him locked down just a little bit longer, Jamie could be dead in this position. Now Nixie's trinket is starting to rotate back up, but they could swap to him before that point, and they're trying to do so. Jamie's right next to him in that group hug formation, just tossing out heals. He's going to survive the swap, only having to trade Barkskin. But if they can bait his trinket with blind and swap to him again, he could fall down. Moving into dampening, Chaz has the mana lead due to the map advantage. He's able to easily escape and get drinks. And with that map advantage, I think Method Black are going to take this.
And look, you can see Chaz. He uses the Tree of Life, so that's a big healing cooldown. Alec is going to have that incarnation coming up in 30 seconds. This is an opportunity for Temple Storm to get some pressure rolling. Kidney shot now on Nixie as they make another big swap on him. Jamie there to support, though, uses the grounding totem, throwing out the off heals, and Nixie should survive with that, not trading out his trinket. It's a big victory for Temple Storm, and now it's time for Temple Storm to get aggressive.
Nixie has been caught in far too many polymorphs in this game, and I think ultimately that is going to cost his team the match. Jamie in a 3-on-1 trying to kite away, caught in a stun, no trinket. Let's see how Temple Storm decide to respond. Nixie trinket Cyclone. Now he does not have trinket for blind. That's going to be devastating moving forward deep into dampening. The momentum is completely in favor of Method Black. Temple Storm needed a decent run in this tournament to make sure that they could secure their spot to BlizzCon. Otherwise, Skillcapped Red is going to have an opportunity to surpass them moving through the rest of the tournament. There's a lot on the line for Temple Storm.
Yeah, it's not over yet, though. Nixie's mana is sort of stabilized with Chaz. Chaz expending a lot of mana to heal through the Moonkin and the Enhancement Shaman damage. Now the setup here onto Jamie, full blind on Nixie. He has no trinket. Jamie in a lot of trouble right now. Trades out the Astral Shift, but I don't think it's going to be enough. The follow-up bash onto Nixie. Jamie keeping himself alive, but a nice Garou coming in from Waz. Is he going to be able to kite away? He needs to get away from Raikou, but Waz might be able to just solo him in this situation. Unfortunately, for Method Black, Jamie's just so tanky and durable. He's able to keep himself alive until that Iron Bark comes in from Nixie that will ultimately keep him alive.
Like Lone on Chaz, Waz trying to get some evasive maneuvers and avoid being attacked while his healer's crowd control. Nice defensive play from Waz. He's always able to kick between defense and offense quite effectively. It's what makes him such a devastating opponent. Now they basically got a huge win condition with no trinket on Nixie, no trinket or Astral Shift on Jamie. Vendetta available, Ice Form available. Method Black have their biggest punch. They just need to swing it properly here, and they should be walking away with game number 5. Let's see if they can execute. Jamie's trying to counter pressure. He's got those Spirit Wolves out. That's going to boost his damage quite a bit here on Waz. Chaz needs to be ready. There's the crowd control. They need to make sure Alec doesn't get any casts off. Alec is actually trying to counter pressure rather than peel. Goes for the Cyclone, gets it on Chaz. This counter pressure forces Waz to trade, but he's got cooldowns to trade, and Jamie doesn't. Waz will always win that race. Nixie was able to sneak in Iron Bark, though. Jamie will restabilize. There's still a 20-second window if Waz can stay on target here and get some nice crowd control. Alec is trying to find a kill with this Incarn rolling. Another Cyclone on Chaz. Waz the target. He got roasted on Runes the Lord around, but looks to be stabilizing here with a defensive kidney shot on Alec. Method Black know they have this in the bag if they can extend it a little bit longer, trying to play defensive. Waz is really the only opening. As long as he's aware of that, doesn't throw the game away.
Ooh, Ascendance!
Black are going to walk away with this. I like this from Waz. Just go across the map. The Enhancement Shaman snared is not going to catch up with you, so this is good by Method Black. I think they should have done this sooner.
That's what they needed to pull, though. They needed Jamie to commit the Ascendance, and once that happens, they can run away safely and freely. Jamie now reconnecting, gets caught into the kidney shot immediately. Waz looking to get counter pressure here. Nice dash over onto Chaz. Alec trying to keep his team in the game. Slow down some of that crowd control coming in from Method Black. Waz ultimately is the one that loses the exchange. He has to run away once again. The Assassination Rogue without those cooldowns is very, very vulnerable. Now that he has the Vanish up, he should be much more confident in pushing in and trying to close out this game.
All right, at this point, it's actually anyone's match. Nixie has Trinket for Blind, Jimmy has Astral Shift, mana's not looking too good for Chaz. It's anyone's match at this point. With Dampening ramping up, it's going to be more and more difficult. Jamie locked down and crowd control, Nixie as well. She's being greedy by not Trinketing this Blind. Greedy move, he Trinkets it late, but he's quite far behind. Chaz is getting counter-pressured, gets Cycloned at low health by Alec. Nice play there. Now they switch their attention to Waz, trying to push him over the edge as well. Jamie uses his stone form, removes all those bleeds, but he didn't save it for Vendetta. I think it would have been a much better trade by Jamie to use that during Vendetta. Now that's a huge opening, potentially. Waz, huge map, kite across it, try and isolate the target. This is exactly what Method Black needs to do. Pull the triple healer group hug apart, bait them into bad positions. Nixie's going to take the opportunity to drink, though. They're trying to punish Alec while he's overextended, but they can't. They're falling behind. Dampening's ramping up. Things are becoming increasingly difficult for both sides.
Yeah, this is a very tense moment. Raikou taking a little bit of pressure. He's forced to retreat behind the pillar as well. Chaz looking for the tranquility, unfortunately not really doing too much. Alex pushes in. Nice bash on Chaz. Raikou getting low. Might be forced into his first ice block. Good pressure from Tempo Storm. This is looking scary for Method Black.
That's a two for one. They got evasion and ice block. Jamie Trinket Astral Shift. Now there's a kill window for both teams at this point. Could be a potential cross kill with Dampening ramping up to such a critical mass. Chaz locked down in crowd control. Jamie staying on target. Waz running for his life. Incarn up in 24 seconds. That's what Alec needs to bank a kill and end this match. Chaz needs to be ready for that and have Tree of Life, but he doesn't have Trinket. If he gets Cyclone on that Tree of Life, his team is just going to disappear from the arena. And Tempo Storm down a man with Nixie healing is going to take out Method Black. Everybody's in trouble at this point. Dampening is so high, they've got one opportunity to get a kill here and now on Jamie. They interrupt Alec, but they don't lock down Nixie. Waz is now on the back foot, and he could easily fall as both teams are in trouble. Alec gets locked on his support. Jamie's dipping low. He's in middle map. Alec goes for a bash, but that Ray of Frost gets wind sheared. Good denial by Jamie. Nixie desperately trying to recover. He needs four more seconds. Incarn's up for Alec. Chaz is fully cycloned. They managed to pull Tree of Life before Incarn. Tempo Storm have a massive win condition, as long as they don't throw.
Yeah, Jamie caught into the kidney shot behind the pillar. That's the problem with chasing Waz. He gets you caught into those stuns. But in the meantime, Raikou, under a lot of pressure from Alec, spamming out the Solar Wrath, gets locked out and deleted out of the game. Tempo Storm with their three-man roster doing the impossible, taking down Method Black.
And you know, this is just such a tough feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.